everyone. Professor Mohammed Shah with you. Today we are going to talk about photovoltaic diesel generator model for standalone applications. You have to specify your folder, go to your destination folder from your drive. Don't open your model from desktop, just copy it in your working folder, going to your main positive folder. Okay, this is my folder. Okay, this is photovoltaic diesel generator for standalone applications, and I have to go here and click on sort by name and group by type in order to organize everything. We have two models, dynamic modeling and manual dynamic modeling. Let's go for the first one. Double clicking, our model should be appear like this. Please check all of this, and now we have everything is fine and ready for running. Okay, what we have here, we have a photovoltaic system, okay, diesel generator and main grid. This system is responsible for load variation depending on your application. This is your application, factory, foundation, facility, home, whatever, and you can control the load by this one. Okay, you can control the, just a click, and you can move the cursor here, you can move the dial controlling your load. Okay, and you can double clicking here and exceed the limit if you'd like to exceed the limit. I will set it at 5000 kilowatts. Okay, and we have here a PV plan. Double clicking here, you can choose between two main models. Solar radiation, if you would like to input your solar radiation as in watt per meter square or kilowatt hour per meter square. I will choose watt per meter square. We already demonstrated that before. And we have diesel generator unit. We can control the following. What is your air pressure or atmospheric pressure, air temperature? What is your fuel? Is it diesel or natural gas, whatever? I think diesel fuel. Air to fuel ratio, okay? So you have to enter your calorific value. Your performance, what is your mechanical efficiency? I think 0.95 is fine. And your volumetric efficiency, 0.85, I think, something, 0.7, something like this. And your power, what is your indicated power pressure? So maybe 15 bars are quite interesting. And for design, you can choose your design, you can control your design, bore, stroke, number of cylinders, two stroke engine or four stroke engine. It's up to you, up to your design, and because this will affect on your fuel consumption. Okay, and we can go on there. This is your main grid. For main grid, we can choose 24 hours operating hours and your kilowatt hour costs. What is your cost depending on your country or your location, whatever. Okay, and we have to, after specifying these operating conditions or design parameters, we can go to control room and we can assign some inputs. This is very important. Is it, we are going to work on PV diesel generator load or main grid load? For main grid or diesel generator, this is your cost, plant lifetime and interest rate, because we are going to calculate your cost. There is a cost analysis inside your block. If you choose PV diesel generator load, you can choose the load variation between both units. For example, if you choose zero, that means that you are going to operate full load on photovoltaic system. If you have choose a diesel generator, you have to select a split ratio for one value, because this will control the load on full control load on diesel generator. Okay, you can choose a percentage between both units. Suppose I'm going for 0.6. I'm sorry, Okay, I have to check here. And hit apply and okay. Okay, double clicking. Let's go for 0.6. Okay. 0.6 means 60% load on diesel generator and 40% load on photovoltaic. And we can explore some parameters going here, and you can choose. This is your photovoltaic grid. We are running on watt per meter square, so I have to double clicking here, and let's see. Your operating hours, normally 8 hours. Solar radiation, I will set it at 1000. Design, what is your module design? Is it 300 module, or I think 280 watt module is fine. Battery depth of charge, performance with your battery efficiency, cost of your battery or battery price. Okay, for this generator, we demonstrated just before. We can go inside here and see your outputs. This is our main outputs. If module efficiency, open circuit current, short circuit voltage, module area, cell area, number of modules, total system area, battery storage, and so on. Okay, for diesel generator, we are going to discover indicated power, friction power, torque, RPM, mean brake power, indicated power efficiency, brake power, swept volume, air volume, and mass flow rate, fuel mass flow rate, specific fuel consumption, and your running cost. For main grid, we can discover our costs. Let's go inside here. We need to discover your annual PV costs, annual diesel generator, annual main grid costs, and total annual costs. Set your simulation time into zero, okay? And we have to click here, saving our model, and let's hit run and see our results. Okay, and okay, for 1 mega, 1,200 kilowatts of power, there is, I think, there's 500 power on load on PV, and there is more load on diesel generator, and there is zero load on main grid power. Okay, for example, I have to go inside here to discover your results. As you can see, open circuit voltage, short circuit current, module voltage, maximum voltage, maximum current, module efficiency, cell efficiency, number of modules, and we have here number of modules, okay, cell area, module area of the system, total system area. This is for 500 kilowatt, and battery results. Let's go for diesel generator. For I think we need to reduce the power on diesel generator a little bit. I think let's go for 60% load on in photovoltaic. I think this is logic. 60% load on photovoltaic. Okay. Okay. That's quite normal. And let's go for diesel generator and trying to discover our results. This is your indicated power, friction power, torque, RPM, main brake power, pressure. Indicated power efficiency, brake power efficiency, swept volume, air mass flow rate, and this is your fuel mass flow rate. This is your consumption, and this is your specific fuel consumption, kilogram per kilowatt hour, and this is your total costs. Let's go inside here. For there is no result for main grid because the load on photovoltaic and diesel generator. Let's go inside this little ratio, and this is our results. I have to check this one. Specific power price, total annual costs, and there is no cost for main grid, okay? And there is cost for photovoltaic and cost for diesel generator. Okay, so suppose I need to run this dynamically. I need to change my result dynamically, so I can set this into infinity and control my inputs. Let's set your infinity and hit run and try to control your dial. Let's control our dial. As you realize, we can control the power from here. Okay, I'm increasing the power load on photovoltaic and diesel generator, and I can manage the variation between posts. Okay, I'm increasing load on diesel generator, and I will decrease load on diesel generator, as you can see here. I'm sorry, as you can see, increasing load, fully load goes to photovoltaic, as you can see. Okay, let's hit stop, and you can realize your results here. Go to data inspector. I'm sorry, going to data inspector, and let's inspect some results. Let's load on photovoltaic, varying as you can see here. Based on this is manual variation, because I choose to change my inputs and the load variation by myself. Load on diesel generator. You can compare posts, as you can see here, opposite. Load in main grid constant, because we didn't run load on main grid. And you can cell efficiency, a specific module area, total system area. Let's go for total system area. Photovoltaic costs, specific power price, and annual total costs. Okay, let's close this one. Suppose I need to run this sure, if you choose main grid, you can select main grid, hit apply and hit run. Let's hit run. You will find your results for main grid and zero for diesel generator and photovoltaic. There is no result for photovoltaic and diesel generator, and the full load on the main grid. Let's go here and double click on dynamic modeling. So this one is it should be run in automatic dynamic mode. Let's saving and close this one. Okay, this one is a little bit different. The same everything, but the condition is completely different. For example, let's go inside here, and you can see this is load condition. For load condition, I choose to do the following. If the load power on is little bit more or higher than the upper limit, this is your limit, upper limit, so I need to utilize the main grid power. And there is no load on photovoltaic and no load on diesel generator. If the load power between below the upper limit and upper than little bit higher than the medium limit, so I need to operate the photovoltaic only. And if your load is below your medium limit and upper than the lower limit, so I need to utilize the percentage of load distribution between photovoltaic and diesel generator. If there is another option, if you are going or intended to go below your lower limit, so there is no chance to but except to operate diesel generator. Full load and diesel generator should be operated and be used. So let's go here. Okay, I choose to run this system within 24 hours. For example, you can add signal builder model, you can add input, you can enter your signal here. Okay, you can control power load, you can do many things you would like. Let's emphasize a little bit. Okay, so I will run within 24 hours, but I have to exceed some okay, let's go for the solver step. I will exceed the step a little bit, 0.001. hit apply. Okay, let's go for diesel generator, and I need to export these outputs to data inspector, so I can copy this. Okay, and going to this signal and double clicking control V, but I have to remove this column. Okay, and then you can check here and send signal to data inspector from here. or for example for friction power, control C. Okay, I have to remove this, I'm sorry, and I forget to do this. And you can click here on this small arrow and click stream selected to data inspector. Okay, and the same for the torque. Let's do it fast way. I have to remove this, I'm sorry. RBM. Brake pressure. Because we need to discover this. Okay, indicated power efficiency. Efficiency indicated power percentage, brake power efficiency, control C. Now we're clicking adding this one and let's remove this. And soup volume, VS, and let's go for air, is for fuel, let's build it. This is very important. You can add what you would like. Okay. And specific fuel consumption and diesel costs, we need this one. So I need to select all of these parameters and click here and select to data inspector. So there is a tiny small square here you can realize. That's the indication that your signal was sent to or has been sent to your data inspector. Let's go here. Okay, so I will run my model and try to change my power load. Okay, double clicking here and see, let's set your upper and lower limits. Suppose I need a 60% load on photovoltaic. Move your cursor arrows. Okay, there's more load on photovoltaic system. That's my upper limit. You can select your upper limit and you can decide based on your design. My upper limit is 2000. Exceeding this limit, that means you are going for main grid operation. And this is my medium limit. This is suitable, relatively suitable for photovoltaic and diesel generator. And this one is suitable for diesel generator. No need for photovoltaic, and we can save our money. Okay, and this I will keep everything as it was. Okay, the same for photovoltaic or diesel generator. I will keep everything as it was. Okay, you have to refer to our previous videos about this one. Okay. I will hit run, saving, hit run and see my results varying. Okay, let's hit run and see. Okay, I'm waiting. Okay, so now we are running on diesel generator because we are below 500 kilowatts. If you exceed your limit, now we are running on both photovoltaic and diesel. Now we are in photovoltaic running area. We exceeded our limit, so now we are running over the upper limit. So we are running on upper limit of main grid. Let's return back again. I am returning back. So I am in photovoltaic. Then I am in photovoltaic and diesel generator. Then I am in diesel generator only, as you can see here, because this is your power 100. Okay. I can stop my running now. I can stop it. Let's go to my data inspector and try to to see my results. You will find your previous results, so you can compare if you would like. But I do prefer to. Okay, let's go for the new results. This is your runs, first run, second run, and then this is your previous run. Okay, this is photovoltaic power. Diesel generator power, okay, and this is main grid power. Okay, let's go here. Photovoltaic, and I'm sorry, I can select my format from 0 up to 7, for example. I'm sorry, This is 5,000, 6,000. Okay, and from up to 6, for example. Okay, as you can see here, my results: main grid photovoltaic and main grid and diesel generator. You can discover, for example, main brake power, horsepower, efficiency. Okay, and diesel cost of your diesel varying, indicated power efficiency, indicated power, total system area, and so on. You have many parameters to discover. You and more than this, you can send your result to a figure. You can copy this data, you can export it, you can send it to a figure from here. Let's go and see. Sending, okay, you can send it, so you can control it, you can deal with it by data, by your tools of data plot. You can control everything. Okay, you can change your line or width. Okay, you can do what you would like. Sure, you can control all of this in dynamic mode, so you can control the load based on your signal builder. You can control your load variation automatically if you would like. We can do this. You can change your upper limit. You can discover your results. You can discover your cost analysis. If you are running on photovoltaic or diesel, because we are running on diesel generator, so there is no results for main grid and photovoltaic, as you can see here. And this is your specific price. It's changing according to your technique of unit that being used. Finally, I would like to thank you very much for your interest in our model. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you very much.